My so-called life is sponsored by...
How's it going? I'm Godless Sewing, and this is the Godless Sewing Channel. So today, I'm going to be talking about Sashiko, Boro, and mending in general, and why I don't know if it borders on cultural appropriation. I would love to hear in the comments what you think about it. Also, I finally got a cat patch that I've been waiting 5 months for. And speaking of mail, I got mail. So Culty of the So Culty channel, which you should be subscribed to, sent me a Serger. Its timing is off, but guess what? So is mine. So, like I always say, strap on, wear a helmet, and let's go sewing! Do you know, there are some people that talk about making the world a better place. And there are others who actually put it into action. So Culty, of the So Culty channel that you should be subscribed to, sent me this beautiful 1034D Serger. And all I can do is dance around like Charlie Wilson in 1980s Venice Beach, California. I am so grateful, it's not even funny. Again, I think So Culty. This is a Brother 1034D. It has 3 to 4 thread serging options, color-coded thread guides, 22 built-in stitches. The speed is up to 1,300 stitches per minute. But like I always say, every week, instead of talking about it, let's go check it out. So, I thought that this was going to be an easy fix because timing, sometimes all you have to do is move a certain part or just oil it and the timing will kick right back on. But no, the timing is completely off on this serger, so I'm going to have to go a bit old school and take it apart completely. And that's okay because this is literally what I do. So, while I'm cleaning this, because I'm gonna defluff it first, because you rarely get an opportunity when you have a serger completely naked like this, you rarely get an opportunity to clean it. So while I'm cleaning this serger, let's talk about my utter and complete love for mending. So, cultural appropriation and unacknowledged adoption is nothing new to fashion, and it's not necessarily something easy to navigate either. Adaptation and development will always happen in an information society, so all you can really do is educate yourself. Sewing and stitching is a way of life for me, so I was naturally drawn towards Sashiko, Boro, slow stitching, and mending clothes in general. But before I get way ahead of myself, Sashiko is an ancient Japanese form of stitching. Back then, most people couldn't afford new clothes or any textiles at all. So the stitches were used to reinforce their clothes and also add warmth. It comes from the need to extend the life of garments. But the stitches became signs of who you were and where you were from. At the time, most people couldn't afford kimonos or the dye it took to make the clothes at all. So Sashiko became a sign of middle and lower class, but it was very popular because of the demand. I encourage you to find anyone who's still practicing Sashiko. All you have to do is type in S-A-S-H-I-K-O and you will be introduced to a whole new world of sewing. I started off with more of a Boro style and kind of graduated to Sashiko, but that goes back to my original statement, or it's kind of a question. What is cultural appropriation? I do not speak Japanese. I am not from there. I can't even begin to understand the stories and the pain and what it took to even make the clothes. So what I'm doing is seeing the stitches and copying that. Is that cultural appropriation? What do you think? Tell me in the comments. Is where you're from properly represented? Or do you feel that cultural appropriation has taken over where you're from? Let me know. And also, boro does not mean happy mending. It's a certain style of stitching, and it was born from poverty. I hear a lot of people saying, oh, boro means happy mending. They say that so they can sell it to you at IKEA. It comes from people who are so impoverished that they had to save everything. And I think it's important to always research the culture that you're usurping, getting into, or whatever you want to call it. I'm not necessarily the best person to ask because I'm a bit of a gatekeeper. I didn't like it when people started rocking flat tops again or when butt packs came back because I have a saying, if you're old enough to remember it, it's not an oldie. But like I always say, research it, look into it. Always do your research. Look into what you're getting into to make sure that you don't look like a complete donkey, because sometimes people will embrace a culture and what they're really embracing is the stereotype. So be careful. That's all I'm saying. So as always, reinforce your seams, be yourself for those who can. If I have not mentioned it 15 times yet, I would like to thank So Culty of the So Culty channel, because it's rare that people do kind things for each other in this world anymore. You know what? I was kind of shocked to get something in the mail that wasn't a bill or something that I sadly ordered from Amazon at 3:00 in the morning. So I thank you. So defluffing is important when you want to prolong the life of a machine. I usually do this with older machines, but like I said, it's really rare that you would take apart a newer serger like this. So I'm taking the opportunity to clean it, and you would be amazed how much junk and gunk gets caught in these things just in a short time of using them. Just in a few swashes, I've got that much already. You know, there's an art form to being a dumpster diver, or what other people call a picker. Yesterday, I was driving home, minding my own business, and I saw this lonely table hanging out next to the trash can. So I walked up to it. It didn't smell bad. It didn't curse me out. So I took it home. Rule number one when you're fixing sergers, stay positive. Light works. You know, as a Westerner, sometimes I don't know where that line is between a cultural appropriation, cultural contamination, or just appreciating a style. Let me know in the comments how you feel, because it's definitely something that we should discuss. Also, if I haven't said it 75 times by now, thank you to Soul Culty for sending me this Serger. Just thank you for being kind. And like I always say, reinforce your seams, be yourself, and I will definitely, definitely see you next time.
I'm the king of rock, there is none higher. Sucker MCs should call me sire. To burn my kingdom, you must choose fire. I won't stop rocking till I retire.
Now we rock the party and come correct. All cuts are on time and rhyme connect. Got the right to vote and we'll elect. And other rappers can't stand us, but give us respect. Like who's cool in the gang? From to the rock, rock to the